Like the pine trees lining the winding road, I've got a name, I've got a name. Like the singing bird and the croaking toad, I've got a name, I've got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did, but I'm living the dream that he kept here. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Like a north wind whistling down the sky, I've got a song, I've got a song. Like the whippoorwill and the baby's cry, I've got a song, I've got a song. And I carry it with me and I sing it loud. If it gets me nowhere, I go there proud. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by.
So when I think back of Norwich Rugby and think of its origins, you can't help but think of Rufus Boyette, a Steve Ingram, who was also my math professor, and Bernie Clark, who also was a faculty member at the school. They're the ones that got us started. They're the ones that brought this odd-shaped ball down to what was a pasture and now is our rugby pitch.
Rugby actually began at Norwich in the spring of 70. I put a notice on the bulletin board, anybody interested in playing rugby, show up at the Upper Parade, which at that time was a playing field. And we had, 15, 20 guys show up. We didn't have a rugby ball, used a football. Local salesman, Rufus Boyette, heard about the programs and had an actual rugby ball sent from his father in England. And so when the fall came and we put out another notice, we had 30-some guys show up. And essentially, it took off from there.
As many people know, the men's program started off as a club back in 1970 and played club rugby for many years. And then back in the early 2000s, you know, we were pretty successful at the Division I level. Went to a couple of national championships, a couple of Sweet 16s, and decided to bring the rugby team under the athletic department and make it a varsity program. And once we did that, we went out and hired full-time coach Bob Wegler, and we've operated that way ever since.
You guys are student athletes and you're human beings, and I do the best I can to mentor you guys. So thank you for winning.
To be on a team, play a sport that they haven't played before, have responsibilities, that's another thing here, you know, on the rugby teams. Even though I'm the head coach, I give a lot of ownership to the team, because at the end of the day, it's their team, and the reason why it's the greatest sport in the world is because it's a player's game. In the 70s and 80s, you know, they had professors and guest coaches come in, and a lot of times, sometimes they were led by, you know, themselves.
It's a player's game, and that's how it's always been. Coach can't go out on the field and play, so it's a player's game, so each of us have to hold each other accountable to go to practice, go to lifts, actually play hard in a game. I feel like that's the main reason why, because we're just a close-knit group of people.
Well, a big part of Norwich Rugby back then, and even into the 80s, was that it was run by the students, and so you had to take responsibility, whether it was setting up the schedule for the next year, it was collecting the dues, to finding out and determining who was going to drive who to the games and back, getting directions, getting the jerseys watched.
First of all, I think I'd like to mention Coach Wegler and his willingness to bring me in 17 years ago. Him as the director of rugby brought this kid out of nowhere, really. I had 4 years coaching experience at the time. He brought me in and said, trust you, give you the opportunity to make this team better. And so I'm really thankful for that. And I think his vision to see that happen is a big part of our success.
Our team really values friendship and sisterhood. We're all connected through the pitch. Blood runs thick through the pitch.
You could count on each other. You could really just like know that the other person was going to have your back when you needed it most.
With knowing that there's 35 years of history behind us, while I was here for the 4 years, I always wanted to do the alumni proud, especially come alumni weekend. They'd all come down different years, and they'd cheer us on, they'd give us advice, and they really loved it. They'd tell us the people that we had behind us, that we were to uphold the status.
We're here at 35 years, but my hope is that we'll continue and we'll keep building the program, keep growing, keep showing women what it's like to, you know, be in a contact sport, play something rough. We have really established something good here, and the people that go to Norwich and are students and alumni, all those values hold true, and I hope they continue to hold true.
The team's camaraderie, the way that they play and represent the university has been tremendous. You know, more and more people are kind of following our suit with hiring full-time coaches and bringing, their programs, you know, under the athletic department, or if not under athletics, emphasizing that program a little bit more than they did when they were at the club level.
We really needed a clubhouse, a place for the student athletes to gather, to see, and to know that this is home. This is their home off campus, to come to get ready in the locker rooms, to do their whiteboarding, to review video tapes, for the coach to sit with them.
We, meaning Austin, Dave, and Dave Whaley, met in his office St. Patty's Day for a very first meeting about what would it look like if we had a new clubhouse, what would be our needs as coaches. We went through that process, we met with the facilities, we met with the architect, and then eventually we got to the point where it may happen. And on October 2nd, Dave Whaley, Alan DeForest, and Randy Gates announced that the campaign. And 6 months later, we had the money to do the project. And I'm very, very excited about it. The players are excited about it. You know, we cleaned out the building, the old building, and everything's in a storage unit right now, and is just waiting for it to start. For me, as a coach, having for 20 years, this is my 20th year, having all those players come back, men and women, to see them again as grown-ups, as mature adults, is exciting for me. And then just all the alumni that have come back all these years supporting me.
It's matured.
Right.
Yep. And, the programs have matured. You know, rugby was a club sport back then.
Yeah.
It's a varsity sport with standing. And they're doing well on a national stage here. And they've really made a name for themselves, and all for the positive. They built upon a lot of great work by our predecessors, some of those guys from 1970 who said, let's learn how to play rugby and let's run a first-class program here and take on all the big boys in Division I.
We're very, very proud of what the program, men and women, tremendous, the professionalism, the level of play is just great, and it's here to stay.
The passion that Rufus Boyette had for rugby just was a great match and really took off, and the guys deserve an awful lot of credit for building the program early on and bringing credit to Norwich University, and I think that's set the stage.
We call ourselves the Scrum Alums, but really it's the old boys, old girls. We have banded together, and even though the game has changed, the way it's played and the professionalism and the athleticism.
Think back to how my life has gone and everything I've learned started here and especially on the rugby field. So I can tell you that rugby has had a huge impact and influence in everything I've done since 1975.
I would say, you know, I think I heard it a little while ago, you know, it's the teamwork. Norwich really teaches you to, that you're part of a team. Teaches you to always hang in there no matter how tough it gets.
Well, when you have a family that works together as a team, you're gonna have a winning attitude. And that's what Norwich Rugby is all about, having that winning attitude to just give it all you got on the pitch for your brothers and for your sisters.
To have my son here now, it's a bond. I mean, it's lifetime. It's, you know, and the whole saying Norwich forever, it's true. That's what it is. We'll always be one. Yeah. We're all one big family.
There's a growth of understanding about friendships that goes so much deeper that the first guy you call when you got a diagnosis of a terminal illness was your rugby teammate. And he was the guy that would launch that next part of your life. And every day we would support one another.
Thank you for giving me a new appreciation on life with Chris Munn. We're always with you, Chris, and the brotherhood that and the band of brothers that's been created around you, Chris, is something that I'll cherish forever, and we play our hearts out for you.
When I play, I remember the people who can't play anymore, especially Chris. That's what we're supposed to do. Every day we come out here, we're supposed to battle for the people who wish they could play one more time, right? That's our job. That's our job.
You see everyone up in the stands where. Right?
Yeah.
All the Norwich Rugby stuff, right? Those are the people that can't play anymore, right? We got to shit for them, right? Chris is up there somewhere right now. He's going to be watching our game. We got to make sure we win this so we can get to the finals and win this whole damn tournament, all right?
Hello, everyone. It's President Anarumo. I just want to say congratulations on 50 years of rugby at Norwich. It's one of our most successful programs, not just on the pitch, but in life. Right, all of you alums that came back, I've talked to a lot of you out there on the road, and you tell me your successes are not born just from your time at Norwich, but in your time as Ruggers at Norwich. So Coach Hall, Coach Wegler, what you do for the young men and women of this school, I'm saying sincerely thank you. You know, we have a lot of our distinguished alumni that are Ruggers. Chairman Alan DeForest and our Board of Trustees right now, who I'm proud to call a friend. Dave Whaley, who's been a mainstay at our school for 40 years now, really goes back to rugby as the seminal part of his experience here on campus. So profoundly successful on the pitch, which I'm very proud of, but incredibly successful in putting out the kind of young men and women that Norwich University can be extremely proud of. So once again, thank you to all, and congratulations on 50 years.
Yeah, everybody would jump in the black van, Archie's van, and we'd head back to Weymouth or wherever, and all points in between, right?
How many kids can you jam into a Cadillac, or an old van, and get down to the rugby tournaments, or go wherever you're going?
Probably stealing the Coast Guard bear for the football team was a highlight. But yeah, there's just so many of them and so many great guys.
Well, we went to England. We played in Hendon, England in the spring of 73. It was a great tour. We did pretty well over there too. And that was Rufus Boyette led the charge, and that was his old club. And Rufus, as you know, was our coach for a number of years. So I'd say the highlight might have been that England tour that we had.
With you!
So congratulations on 50 years.
Cheers to many more guys, congrats.
Awesome, well done.
I started here 17 years ago, and I think the first day of practice with that group, I said to them, we're gonna win a national championship in 3 years from now. And they looked at me like I was absolutely out of my mind.
My experience of Norwich Rugby is about family. Just being there for my brothers and my sisters and just coming back to school and just playing and leaving it all on the pitch.
How much I enjoyed the camaraderie. Guys who I hadn't talked to in 20 years, I pick up the phone and it's like we had talked yesterday.
I think because of what we went through together, you know, Rook Week and then the bonds were built. And I mean, I think Dennis would attest. I mean, look at now, we're almost 40 years out, and I mean, we still stay in touch, and it's just, it's a brotherhood. We always talk about it, right?
Shared experiences, shared pain.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
It's the ball of number 12, Allison Day.
We just knew that we enjoyed playing it. It was different. and the camaraderie that came with it.
Seeing all these guys, seeing all the play, playing all the rugby, it's national championships, past couple years, you know, the memories, building the memories.
I'm so thankful for every individual that I've met through this sport, alumni, current players. People come up to me when I'm home in Virginia and they see my Norwich rugby jacket. Oh, hey, I knew a guy, my roommate was a rugby player. He's one of the best guys I knew in college. And you get the reputation that you guys have set forth for myself and the rest of my current teammates now. You know, you guys are just setting us up for success.
Well, when you're running down the pitch and you're in full speed and somebody behind you yells with you, that means you have somebody at your back in support, somebody you can pass the ball to. So, after you've graduated and you're in life and you need somebody at your back supporting you and you say with you, you know what that means. That means you have my support 24/7, and anything might be going wrong in your life or challenging your life, you know you have brothers for life that will be there with you forever, on and off the pitch.
Down the highway.